Woke up, I just hit them with the low cut, then call my folks up. Somebody about to get poked up, go call a tow truck. All that talking out your neck might just get your throat cut. This a Mack truck, not a black truck. When we move, tell them back up. Click, click, clack, duck. Hella.
We're back with another YouTube video, y'all. My name is Simply Nafetti. Damn, just messed up. Okay, so I've been missing in action for a reason. So I didn't give up on YouTube. I don't want people to think I gave up on YouTube or anything. But, like, I gotta announce it, y'all. I am currently 5 months pregnant. It's tiny. But yeah, y'all, I'm pregnant. And it's the girl. So my due date is December 25th of 2022. So hopefully she comes then. Or it comes before. Because I really don't want to push on Christmas, y'all. Because I want to spend time, like, I want my family and shit to see her, even though she's going to be, like, a couple days old. But y'all know the vibes. I'm just really excited. But, like, I don't know, bro, because it's the 25th. And they changed my due date at least once. Because the first due date I had was originally for December 23rd. And then now it got pushed all the way to December 25th. But I think I want to do what this YouTube video is going to be about, kind of like a story time and like just the stuff I've been going through pregnant, like morning sickness and shit. If I knew y'all had morning sickness, nobody could have got a kid for me, okay? Nobody. I wouldn't have had sex, bitch. My legs would have been closed, bitch. I got married though. Oh yeah, that's another thing too, y'all. I got married in April, so it's like, okay, let me just break the story down to y'all. All right, y'all. So, okay, so here's the story. So, bada bang, bada boom, your girl found out she was pregnant in April. So, keep in mind, y'all, April was the month I actually, like, started to be like, I'm gonna start going out. I was making friends with people because I'm no longer friends with people that I don't put myself around no more, because that's just, it ain't really, like, too much I could say. But, bitch, like, no, it's just not gonna ever happen again. So, we gonna leave it like that. And that's straight with me. I wish him the best. But, y'all, you would never be in my life again. Especially not with a kid now. I feel like this kid has matured me to the point of my mindset and just how I am with people. Like, I think before I even knew, because I was pregnant, but I didn't know I was pregnant. So, like, the way I was kind of already acting towards people, like, I was already getting fed up. You know, I was kind of already being moody, but I didn't know I was pregnant. So I found out in April, but keep in mind, like I said, I started to go out more. I was making new friends, you know, girl was drinking, getting drunk, things like that. And then boom, I was like, okay, you know what, I think I want to get married. So I'm telling y'all a story step by step. So we going out and shit, but I'm like, okay, I think I want to get married. So me and my current husband went downtown and we went to the courthouse. Yeah, we went to the courthouse and we had to pay like $100 and some tax for our marriage license. So like, keep in mind though, y'all, I started going out, like I would say I was hanging out and shit around April 1st. And then like, as it was transitioning, like, you know, you going out, you having fun, like, ooh, bitch, you know, you nigga. Like, ooh, baby, I'm feeling you, you know. So we tied the knot on the 14th of April. And then, y'all, I woke up one morning. And this was the day I was supposed to expect my period. But, like, me, I was kind of already experiencing, like, symptoms a little bit. Like, I was having bad breast pain. But I'm like, nah, bitch, it might just be your period. It ain't nothing serious. So I'm like, okay. So I was getting breast pains. Then, y'all, I was craving the fuck out of Caesar salads. Every day, Caesar salad. Mind you, I was working at Walmart. So every day, I would get a Caesar salad. And then before the deli would close, like, I couldn't even, like, just snack on stuff like how I would used to, just eating chips and stuff, through my shift. No, I had to go over to the deli, y'all. I was eating chicken, baked beans, macaroni and cheese for lunch. Like, all kind of crazy shit, bro. And then I had a bad, like, addiction to, like, these Dorito Dynamite chips. Them bitches are so good. They look kind of like Takis, but just the Dorito brand. But, yeah, y'all. So, like, those are, like, pregnancy signs, but I never, like, fully paid attention to them. So, finally, I took the test on the 18th when I got up. Like, I woke up in the morning. I was like, you know, I know I'm a bitch. I'd be fucking raw. Me and my nigga would be hunching. Let me take the test, because me personally, I've always done that. Like, knowing that I'm sexually active, even though it's just with one partner and we're still in a relationship together, like, I've always been big on going to the hospital, or, you know, if not the hospital, if I don't have time for hospital, you know, setting up an appointment. But if I can't get the appointment, bitch, I'm gonna go to the hospital. But, like, I've always just been the type of person to keep up on my health, you know, take pregnancy tests. Like, I would take pregnancy tests literally I'll take a pregnancy test at least once a week, because just at the fact, like, me knowing I'm drinking, I'm sexually active, I'm not using a condom with this person at all, like, ever, and knowing, like, you know, they putting the business up in you, like, I had to, you know, keep cautious, be alert to it. So, y'all, the test came back positive. I'm just in the bathroom, like, bitch. I just said in February, I would never get pregnant. These niggas can't get me pregnant. It'll never happen. But it's just crazy how, like, I feel like when we tied the knot, that's when God was like, okay, you know what? You have your baby now. So I was like, oh, okay. But I prank him so much, y'all, to the point where, like, he's always wanted a baby with me since we've been together for, like, the last 2 years, almost 3 years now. This man, like, was legit always wanted to get from me. And I was just, you know, a funny bitch pulling pranks on him, or, like, I was also on depo at a point in time, too. So, like, I really wasn't making no babies. So, basically, when the depo finally wore off, which was this year, I guess stopped taking depo for, like, a whole year. That's another thing, too, ladies. If you guys are on birth control, like, bro, I will honestly say, like, I would never get personally back on birth control due to the side effects that it gave me for bleeding for, like, 3 months straight. Bitch, I got a depo shot one time, y'all, and that was in 2020. Okay, yeah, so y'all, I did get a depo shot in 2020 of November, because I was, like I said, I went through a miscarriage, and I didn't want no more kids, like, after that experience, because honestly, like, that was the most traumatic experience for me ever, like, and I'd have been through a lot, like, your girl done been through a lot, like, I didn't grow up without having a mama, which I done grew up with, bitch, my daddy not even, like, really being there for me and stuff like that, like, I done went through a lot. You feel me? But that right there, I feel like, broke me the most. And that's why, like, I did get on depo, because I was scared, like, to just, I wasn't scared to, you know, get pregnant. I was just scared to go through that situation again. Like, you know, like, I would never be scared of, you know, having a kid, because at the end of the day, fucking, you know what you're doing. Like, you know, it takes two people to have a kid. If you laying up with somebody, if you know you're getting, you know, plugged in, you already know, like, what's up. You feel me? So, that was, like, never the scenario for me and my me getting depo. But, yes, y'all. He didn't believe me too much, like I said, because I would prank him so much. Like, and it's so bad. Now that I think about it, like, I probably hurt his feelings, because it's, like, to want something so bad with the person, but you out here, like, especially, like, if you're out here fucking up and doing other shit, and bitch, karma come back, and you, and they get their licks, you feel me, now you stuck in situations that you gotta deal with the next person that you really don't wanna be involved with, compared to, like I said, where I feel like God was like, bitch, you're not gonna get no kid from this girl till y'all married, because me, younger, I would always literally, like, I feel like whatever you say in the world, the shit you manifest is, like, literally everything, so I used to always tell myself, I'm never gonna get pregnant until, you know, I'm married. And boom, as soon as we got married on the 14th of April, 18th, I kid you not, on the 18th, I was pregnant. And this has been my little blessing ever since then. Anyway, and I'm going to show you guys a little ultrasound. So yeah, this is my little nugget, y'all. Thanks for your time. Mm-hmm.